Tell prism of base side 30 mm and axis height is 70 mm resting on HP on its base side. So this is a pentagonal prism which consists of pentagonal base and pentagonal top face. Pentagonal prism consists of rectangular faces, so 5 rectangular faces and 2 pentagonal top and bottom face. So this is a longer edge which consists of 2 rectangular faces as a part. So as of now, question is, a pentagonal prism resting on base on HP on its side, base side. So this is the side. So as we follow resting parameter, we draw on the right side. So I need to draw this line as a base edge or base side on the right. So I will draw corresponding front view as a rectangle with the dimension of axis height and this dimension, and top view as a pentagonal plane with the dimension as a side dimension 30 mm. So first I will start with a top view. Resting on base side or base edge, so I will draw a pentagon of a given dimension, let's say 30 mm. So this dimension of a pentagon is 30 mm. So draw a line 30 mm. Then at this 2 point, take 108 angle, included angle for pentagon. Take a same length as, let's say this is 30 mm. Take 30 mm distance in compass, mark on this. The corresponding angles are 108. This as well as this. Now from these two ends, take same distance and mark the arc. You will get a pentagon. Join it . Let's say notations are resting edge or side as AB, so I'm giving notation like this, ABCDE. Similarly, top face as 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. As it is prism, so again find out its center to draw the axis. So I will join this D with opposite midpoint and E with opposite side midpoint. So let's say this is a point O, center point. Now project this center point to mark the axis in the front view. So I have drawn axis line by projecting this O point in the front view. I know axis height is 70 mm, so from this XY line I will mark 70 mm. Let's say this point is, let's say we'll just mark the point on axis, this height is 70 mm. This is axis height 70 mm. Now project the points AB, this D point, similarly this C and E here. I draw the front view as rectangle. As observer position is here to draw this, so nearest point is C. So this line CE, this, it should be a visible dark line. So I can see this edge as well as this edge. So one, this two as well as three are visible lines. And line passing through this, that is, it is an axis line which I already marked. So this is complete front view. give the notations base as AB. So this point is AB. Similarly, this point is C, E as CE on same line. This point is D. This is as axis, you can say OO dash. Now, top face of this edge is 1, as this is 1, 2, so 1, 2, 3 and 5, so this is a projector of 3 and 5, and this is point number 4, so top face 4. So this is complete front view and top view for first stage. Now let's say with this first stage of a pentagonal prism, I will add second conditions, combinations of second conditions. Let's say a simple first case, a prism is inclined to HP. So instead of that, I'll say the simple case, a base. So always a second condition for solid problem is angle with respect to HP. So with respect to HP, let's say first condition is, I'll say first condition, base is inclined to HP. So second condition, first parameter, as it is a very simple case, a base is inclined to HP. Let's say angle I'm giving as 30 degrees. So I'll say theta made by base with HP. So HP, that is logical theta. So now this is a base polygon ABCDE. See, a pentagonal prism resting on base edge. Now it is inclined to HP. And in second stage it is inclined to HP. They have given angle for base. So in front view you can see this is one line, or this means basically this line view. Means I need to draw this angle theta as 30 degree made by this base. So base is making angle with HP is 30 degree. So simple, I'll draw this line keeping this as resting side. This is resting side. So this I'll keep on XY. Resting side is AB. AB. This is inclination. So first stage, second stage, angle made by this line on this side, base. This is base. This angle with HP is 30 degree. Right? So I'll just copy this view by taking an angle 30 degree with HP. So let's say this is the point I'm taking on this XYAB. Now base polygon is this. It is making an angle 30. So I'll locate, I'll just take one 30 degree line. Now measure the length AB to D in compass, AB to D, from this AB marked 1 arc. From AB marked 1 arc. Let's say this is 30 degree angle. Remember, this is the angle made by base with HP. So theta made by base. So I've taken this angle 30 degree, this angle as 30. Take AB to D distance from this front view first stage, mark from AB on this 30 line. Now just copy this view. As these angles, as the prism is 90, I'm going to take perpendiculars at this 2 lines. Now, take the distance AB to CE. From AB, mark this distance, AB to CE. So I will just mark it. So this point is AB, this point is D, and this point is C, E. Similarly, this corner is 1, 2. This is 3, 5, and this one is 4. Now take a projection, you will get the second stage top. Now just locate the points corresponding polygon base and top faces. So let's say this is point D, and I'm having the projector of D and this D. So accordingly locate all the points. This is point E. This point will be point E. Okay, this point is point number 4 on the projector of 4. I need to locate. This is point 4. So DE, projector of A. This is projector of B. So join AB. Similarly, this is C projector, and this point will be C. So join as a pentagonal base. Similarly, locate the points. This is point number 1, 2. This will be point number 3, 5, and 4. Just join it. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 5. Join 5 with 4. So what I did, ABCDE as a base polygon, and 1 2 3 4 5, I have located the point, then join all the points. Now apply our rules to get it top view. First rule is outer edges are visible. So E5, this one, so they are visible dark line, continuous thick line. So what is the position of observer here? This perpendicular to this plane. So for this observer, nearest point is 4. So line passing through 4 point in this view are visible, because that's nearest one. So this is 4 1 4 5 4 3. So I need to make this line passing through 4 as 4, 5, 4, 3 are continuous line. Now farthest point is AB. So line passing through A and B will be hidden lines. So this is A point. So I need to make this AE, AB as well as B the hidden lines. So first I will make this. Now we need to join edges A1, B2, these edges. So I will join E5. Similarly, A1, so as the point A is the farthest, it should be B2, again it is farthest point, but as a pentagonal prism, we need to have how many edges? 5. E5, 1, A2, 2, 3, 4. One more, D2, which is thick line. So that's complete second stage top. So for this problem, simple one, see all these outer edges are visible first. Second, line passing through nearest point is 4. So 4 line is 1, 2 and 3 are visible. Farthest is AB. So A and B, all the line passing through A and B should be hidden lines. So that is AE, A1, AB, BC and B2 are invisible lines. So that's second stage. Now that was the case when the base angle given for prism. Now we'll change this angle to understand the different cases of prism. Let's say as this angle made by base was 30. This angle was 30 degree. So we'll see different combination for same solution first. So what could be another sentence or to this but solution is same. So what I'll say, if this angle made by base is 30 degree, what should be the angle made by this edge? And what is this edge? AB 212. What is that AB 12? So let's see first, let me clear with the concept. This is a pentagonal prism resting on base edge. So we solved the first case simple when angle made by base was given. And we drawn something second stage front end top view. Let us say, now I know as same solution but different formation of question. Now this angle was 30. So what should be angle made by this line and what is this line? So what is this? It is a rectangular face contained by resting edge. Resting edge is AB, right? Its rectangular face is AB 12. This is AB 12. It is making an angle. So if this angle is 30, what should be the angle made by this face? That should be 60. And how it is so? Very simple. If this angle is 30, it is a rectangle, this angle is 90. So total is a straight line, total angle is 180. So 180 minus this 90, so this becomes 90. So if this is 30, this angle should be always 90 minus angle made by base. So if angle made by base is 30, angle made by this rectangular face will be 60 degree, right? Means I will get the same solution if the question is, now see another sentence for same solution. A rectangular face contained by resting edge on HP is inclined at how much? 90 minus this means 60 degree to HP. Always second condition. So if the question is the resting rectangular face, resting is AB, its face is AB 12. AB 12 is making 60. That simply means base is making 30. So we drawn first case, first problem as angle made by base is 30. That simply means angle made by this face is 60. So same solution but another formation of question. Now what may be another sentence for again same solution? Means we'll be having same problem but another case. That is third question. Now let me clear, if I have drawn axis here, O dash same I can copy, let's say I have drawn axis here. Take the distance AB to O and draw axis. Let's say this is OO dash. You can give any notation, no problem. So I draw an axis. So if I say here axis is inclined to HP, third, axis is inclined to HP at angle of 60 degree. Now axis is inclined to HP 60 degree. Now from diagram we'll get to know this line as a face and this axis is parallel, right? So this face and axis for prism is always parallel. Therefore angle made by axis as well as angle made by this face is same. So I'll say this solution and this solution is again one and the same. So for prism, angle made by either this face or axis is one and the same. One more question may arise, what is the angle made by this edge? Now one more question but the same solution. I'll say, now see the question, I'll write here. Longer edge passing through corner point longer edge passing through the corner point opposite to resting edge. So longer edge opposite to resting edge. Resting edge is AB, its opposite corner is this D, right? Longer edge passing through the corner point opposite to the resting edge. Resting edge is AB, its opposite corner is D. It's so AB opposite corner D. Its corresponding longer edge is D4. So now D4 is making an angle 60 degrees with HP. Is making an angle or incline at 60 degree to HP. So what it means? This D4 line is inclined at an angle 60 degree. I'll say D4. Longer edge passing through this corner, D4. So this angle is 60. So as we know, this longer edge axis as well as this face is parallel to each other, all the angles are same. So again I will get the same solution. So this is a question when I'll say n number of formation of sentence, but the solution is one and the same, as it is simple and similar to the first case. I'll check first. For pentagon, how? Join any two corner with opposite midpoint. Means I have drawn D faint line to perpendicular and making just finding out midpoint of AB. Join any two corners with opposite midpoint. Means D opposite side is AB. Its midpoint like this. So join it. Then another any corner, let's say E. I have drawn one line. Its opposite side is this. Its midpoint is somewhere here. So join it. So intersection of these two lines will be this. I can take A. Opposite side is CD. Its midpoint will be this. So it will pass through this O point only. Got it? Okay.